TeamVLR, George here, back again with another video. This time around, I will be discussing some cards that have great potential for the Link Monster format, accompanying the new Vrains Yu-Gi-Oh! Series. These cards can either help extend Link plays, or stop them altogether. So without further ado, let's get started. First up is Blasting Fuse, a fairly old trap card from Cyber Dark Impact. When four cards occupy the same call Blasting Fuse is set in, meaning your spell and trap zone, your monster zone, your opponent's monster zone, and your opponent's spell and trap zone, you can destroy all four cards in said column. What's interesting about this card is that it seemingly also works with the extra monster zone, meaning you can place this trap in the spell and trap zone directly under your opponent's extra monster zone. However situational, this card is still worth considering. Next up is another Cyber Dark Impact card, Storm Shooter. Storm Shooter has two effects that manipulate zones. It can either manually move to adjacent monster zones, or return a spell or trap or monster in the same column on your opponent's side of the field back to their hand. This card, with some protection, can continuously shift his position and deal with your opponent's link plays, making for a very versatile monster. Darkness Approaches is another interesting tech. In the Shonen article that announced the new format, a specific card ruling was mentioned, specifically how a link monster's position could not be changed, and they could also not be flipped into face-down defense position by cards like Book of Moon. However, a card like Darkness Approaches flips your opponent's monster face-down without changing its position, seemingly working around the clause. I am still unsure as to what happens to the zones extra deck monsters are linked to when said link monster is no longer face up on the field, but regardless of this, Darkness Approaches has its uses. Next is Phantasmal Lord Ultimatal Bish Balkan, Zulkin's less cool older brother. Essentially, on either player's main phase, Bish Balkan can summon tokens to both sides of the field so as to summon as many monsters as possible. This means that with a well-timed Bish Balkan effect, every link zone can be occupied with useless tokens, thus halting your opponent's link plays. However, if it is possible to use tokens to summon link monsters, and Bish Balkan's tokens happen to be the correct materials for a fairly decent link monster, this card might not see any play at all. These next couple of cards all fall into the same category of effect, so I will attempt to group them up for efficiency's sake. First is Trihead Dust Dragon. At the steep cost of 3 level 4 monsters, you can target one unused zone, whether it is a spell and trap or monster zone, and it cannot be used while this card is face up on the field. But, and this is a big but, this effect can only be activated when your opponent controls more cards than you, which usually means they had a turn before you to set up and already did their plays. Numbing Grub in the Ice Barrier is similar to Trihead Dust, in that you can select an unused zone, specifically a monster zone this time around, when it is summoned and that selected zone cannot be used while Grub is face up on the field. A little better than Trihead in terms of utility, however Grub is far from the best of this bunch. Zany Zebra is a pendulum monster that had a lot of potential ever since its release in Breakers of Shadow. Both its pendulum and monster effects are as follows. Choose an unoccupied zone. It cannot be used while this card is face up on the field, either as a skill or monster. Zany Zebra also happens to be a 7th skill, making it very compatible with a lot of pendulum decks. After that pendulum nerf, this is exactly what the mechanic needs as a whole and will probably see some play. These next couple of cards are a part of one archetype, so I will also group them up for time's sake. Ojama Knight allows you to select two of your opponent's monster zone. These zones can no longer be used. Ojama King has a similar effect, however you are able to choose 3 zones. Seeing as how Knight can use any 2 Ojamas as opposed to King's fairly specific materials, it will probably be seeing the most play. The 1 zone difference does not matter as much, so long as you are able to target your opponent's extra monster zone before they can use it. Ojama Trio, another in-archetype card, is also quite useful in the Link Monster matchup. It is a trap that summons 3 Ojama tokens to your opponent's side of the field. When your opponent has invested resources into a Link Monster, chain this card and occupy the Link zones to stop their plays. There's also an added bonus of 300 burn damage to your opponent each time one of the tokens is destroyed. Sinus Switch is a card that has great synergy with the Link Monster mechanic. It is a continuous spell that allows you to move a monster to an adjacent and unoccupied monster zone once per turn. Simply summon an extra deck monster to a Link zone, move it over with Sinus Switch, and you are now able to summon another extra deck monster. I can see this kind of card becoming a staple in a lot of decks. An equally powerful card holds our final slot in the video, and this is of course Ground Collapse. Ground Collapse is a continuous spell that allows you to select 2 monster zones on the field. The other player can use said monster zones. The Link Monster mechanic is interesting in that your opponent can't have an extra monster zone until they either summon a monster to it, or you summon a monster to yours. A card like this would not be played in an anti-Link deck, but would instead be a side deck card to help with a matchup for either player. This is not to say there are no issues with the card. There is a chance that the card could get an errata, allowing it to only target main monster zones. It can also get banned entirely as to not ruin Konami's new mechanic. In either case, it is in my opinion that a card that could see the most play in a Link era Yu-Gi-Oh! Well, these were a couple of interesting tech cards for the up-and-coming Vrains format, courtesy of TeamVLR. Tell me what you guys think about the changes down below. Do you like them or do you oppose them with every fucking cell in your body? Also, let me know if I missed any cards, and TeamVLR George is out.